So you're the proud owner of a new vintage lens and you want to tell what defects that lens has, maybe to decide if you want to keep it or send it back. Obviously, you blow away the surface dust and clean the lens with fiber cloth and alcohol. To look into the lens without disassembly, you're going to need a light source. Ideally, you use one with an adjustable arm, like an ordinary desk lamp. Shining the light from the back into the lens will light up the defects we want to examine. It's a bit tricky to get the right angle, but if you play around a bit, you immediately see when it happens. You can use a darker object or even a finger between the lens element and the light source to make tiny specks and defects more visible. It is important to always pay special attention to the edges of the glass. If you examine a zoom lens, it is important to zoom through the range as some defects only get visible at a certain zoom factor. A phone with a good camera that offers close focus and magnification helps a lot. You can magnify the image to better judge what you see. The shallow depth of field of the close focus makes it easier to discern the position of the given surface. And you can document the defect by taking a photo or a video. Scratches. Some scratches are obvious when a sharp object cut into the surface of an element. This is often the tool damage that can also happen inside a lens during an unprofessional service. You can not only see those scratches, but you can feel them too. The tip of your finger usually does the job, but when you play guitar and your tips are a bit leathery, you can also use your fingernail. Some common scratch marks are caused by the lens being dragged over a surface. Typically, these marks show up in the center of the front element. Scratches can be visible at high f-stops and cause flares, depending on their position. Cleaning marks are very small scratches that are predominantly circular. They are caused by particles on the lens or in the cloth while the lens is cleaned. Cleaning from the inside out and with little pressure reduces the risk of leaving marks. And of course, surface and cloth needs to be clean. Cleaning marks usually only affect the coating. When you touch the glass with your fingertip, you can't feel the scratches as they are not deep enough. Very severe cases like this example could be described as haze causing degradation of the image quality and flaring. Lens elements are often glued together in groups. These groups are not taken apart during rehousing. If the adhesive deteriorates over decades, it can cause various problems. Separation is one of them, meaning that the bond between two lenses starts to loosen. Usually, this happens from the outside first, as humidity enters the system from the outside. But it is also possible to have separation in the center of a group, usually caused by thermic reactions. Haze can be caused by surface contaminants like water vapor trapped inside the lens. This can be easily cleaned when you open the lens. Haze can also be a fungus, but this will have specific patterns we will show in a moment. Like described before, separation can cause a haze on the edges or in the center. This sample lens is home to several little aliens. Fungus can be easily identified by its plant-like shapes. It grows inside a lens if the humidity is high over prolonged times. Fungus can be cleaned, but it also eats into the coatings over time. It is critical how long the fungus was active. Glass can have chips and cracks when it has been dropped or too much tension is applied to an element. Chips can be invisible in the image when they're off-center, but they can also cause flares. The paint inside of a lens barrel can come off due to chemical process like corrosion or mechanical damage, for example caused by tools. This example is a group that has paint defects that might cause flaring. As it is inside the group, the paint defect is likely to be chemical degradation rather than caused by tools. For rehousing, only paint defects inside a group are important as the rest is replaced. Radiation or thorium inside a lens element can cause a crystallographic defect called F-center. The glass turns more and more yellow over decades, acting like a filter. Besides the shift in color, the transmission gets reduced. Just like rust on a classic car, this is not considered a vintage characteristic. The effect is completely reversible by exposing the lens element to UV light. And no, the radiation is not dangerous to you unless you grind and eat the lens. An iris can show mechanical defects and can be affected by contaminants. This is only important if the iris is not replaced in the rehousing. Cleaning can potentially damage the iris. Now, which of the defects are critical depends on many factors. Contaminations can be cleaned. Radiation defects can be cured. An iris can be replaced. How severe is the defect? Where is it located? How picky is the customer? And of course, how rare is the lens? If there is no alternative, one has to be more flexible. Severe damages to the coatings are problematic. Removing and replacing a coating can damage the lens. Also, modern coatings are very different to contemporary ones. Separation has the same problem. While it's technically possible, it is complex. No rehouser offers fixing separation or coatings as far as we know.